All right, it is my pleasure to call to order the special meeting for the Dayton School District and the Dayton School Board of Education on this June 30th of 2020. May I have a roll call, please?
President Alhamdani.
Present.
Dr. Harris.
Present.
Dr. Pickett.
Present.
Ms. Reiner.
Present.
Mr. Sampson.
Present.
Mr. Smith.
Present.
Ms. Wiegany.
Present.
Seven present.
Thank you. Let's stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
for which it stands,
one nation, under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you all. Superintendent, you have some recommendations for us.
Yes, the first recommendation is to waive the 48-hour rule. It's my recommendation to waive that rule.
You're requesting that to be waived for the Human Resources, Item B, and for the Resolution of Administrative and District Support Staff Salary Freeze. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
It is so moved by me. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved by me, second by Dr. Harris. Any questions on the waiver? All right, hearing none, let us vote.
President Alhamdani.
Yes.
Dr. Harris.
Yes.
Dr. Pickett.
Yes.
Mrs. Reiner.
Yes.
Mr. Sampson.
Yes.
Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Ms. Wiegany.
Yes.
Seven yeses.
All right, motion passes. Your first item, Dr. Lally.
Yes, I'd like to recommend to the Board of Education that they approve the Human Resources agenda that's here. The board will note that we are filling the position of middle school principal at Belmont with Mr. OJ, who has been with us for several years. And we are changing the assignment of Mr. Seard to support Thurgood Marshall as an assistant principal this year. Mr. Wright has a change of assignment, actually a change of title as well. He is now the Chief of Safety and Security because he's had additional job duties added to him, including truancy and also the hearing officer role, not the role of hearing officer, but managing the hearings that we have in the district, the student hearings. We also have the addition of Executive Director of OEC Policy and Procedures, Laura Collier, coming to us from Centerville. This is that position that we did not fill after we had the death of the person in that position. We've changed the title slightly, and she will be working on that report that we're expecting to get in August about our OEC from the Ohio Department of Ed. We are also hiring an executive director for athletics, Victoria Jones. She is returning to the Dayton area and bringing with her a great deal of experience, as are the other people that we've talked about so far. Karen Lombard is being hired as the academic coordinator of early childhood education. So she'll be doing the preschool. Academic coordinator preschool is what that should say, not early childhood education. That should say academic coordinator preschool for Ms. Lombard in her position for next school year.
All right. Is so moved. Is there a second?
Second.
It's moved by me, saying by Karen Wiegany. Any questions, comments about the recommendations from the superintendent?
I have a few questions, Mr. President.
Sure.
Superintendent, can you remind me, line number 4 for the Executive Director of OEC Policy and Procedures, how long was that position unfilled following the death of the previous employee? And go ahead.
I apologize. It's been unfilled for the last 3 years.
Oh, okay. And you said you changed the title somewhat. Is the job itself changing at all, or is it just a clarification?
No, the job actually is changing. Before it was just called executive director or director of OEC. And that was the support member who worked with the academic coordinators and the chief of OEC. What we're trying to do is have someone who focuses exclusively on the report that's coming out from the Ohio Department of Ed. We have been told, we have not seen it, but we have been told that it is a massive report and that there are quite a number of things that we need to focus on and that we need to make sure that we have prepared to change and or implement. So this person will take care of those policies, those procedures, those things in that report, and make sure then we have a plan to follow up for implementation, professional development, that sort of thing. And then after that point, you'll probably see me come back and change the title back to the original title, because that person would then be able to support the academic coordinators that work in our buildings. But for this coming school year, at least, it's totally about the policies, the practices, the procedures, and the report.
Okay, thank you, Superintendent. That's all I have, Mr. President.
All right, anybody else with any questions? Go ahead, Mr. Sampson.
Quick question, Doc. With the change in assignment for Thurgood assistant principal, is there going to be a need to fill the truancy position?
The hearing officer position? The truancy? No, I don't think so. I have not had that conversation yet with Mr. Terry, but I will have that conversation with him. I think I had requested a plan for truancy from him a few months ago. And as with everything else with our planning and our movement, things got a little stalled this spring. But I'm sure that we have to have a conversation again about what his beliefs are about the truancy. But right now he's still at the same number that he was at before. Mr. Seard was an additional one.
Thank you.
I'd like to point out that I'm glad to see that we're putting OJ in a position to succeed potentially in the future and to grow our own. That's a big step for us. I hope he does well over in Belmont. To bring back a former DPS athlete and UD athlete, and that's a good, I think that's a step in the right direction for athletic department. Hopefully once this gets approved, I hope and my wish is for athletic department to take off, especially when you're bringing back somebody like that into our district. And I'm glad to see growth for other people within here, especially Mr. Wright. He's been a solid bedrock for us through some difficult times in the district. So I'm very happy to see that as well. So there are no further questions. It's been moved, second, and discussed. If there are no further questions, I will ask for a vote.
President Alhamdani?
Yes.
Dr. Harris?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Reiner?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mrs. Wiggany?
Yes.
7 yeses.
All right. Motion passes. Your next recommendation.
My next recommendation is to pass a resolution that freezes all administrators and district support staff salaries for the 2020-21 school year. This is because of a projected deficit in the five-year forecast in the year 2022, trying to make sure that that we are fiscally sound and doing what we need to do. So the resolution is for that freeze to occur.
All right, so moved by me. Is there a second?
Second.
I move the second. Karen Wood Gagne. Any questions? Comments? I will say, like everybody else, we're going through a very difficult time right now, as a district, as a community, as a state. And it's really hard for us to predict what the future holds. And based on projections of potential cuts to our budget from the state, we're all going to have to be asked to make some major sacrifices over the next few months. So I hope we can all stick together and move the district in the same direction we've been moving for a while. And I hope we are all prepared to make the sacrifices that we need. It's a very difficult time for everybody in the state, everybody in this country. And we feel the pain of the administrators and the support staff that we're asking to take this step with us. All right, there are no other comments or concerns or questions. Let us vote.
President Alhamdani?
Yes.
Dr. Harris?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Reinhardt?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Wiegany?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Dr. Lally, does that conclude your recommendations?
Yes, that concludes my recommendations for this evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Lally. Madam Treasurer, is your turn?
I recommend that the board approves the resolution for the fiscal year 2020 amended certificate of estimated resources. We'll go to the document. As you can see on this document, we started with unreserved fund balance of July 1st, 2019, 170.6 million. We received property taxes, 90.2 million. Other sources, 281.2 million. When we say other sources, from the state, federal, local, and other miscellaneous. So the final estimated certificate for fiscal year 2020 is 542.1 million.
Thank you, Treasurer. I'd like to move the motion to the floor. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. I don't know who said it first. You can go take your pick, Treasurer. It's either Ms. Wiegany or Vice President Reinhardt.
Okay. I put Reinhardt.
All right. There you go. Been moved and seconded. Any questions on the motion? Hearing none, let us vote.
President Alhamdani?
Yes.
Dr. Harris?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Reinhardt?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Wiegany?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Motion passes. Your next recommendation, Madam Treasurer.
I recommend that the board approve the following resolution for supplemental appropriation measure for fiscal year 2020 final.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any questions on the motion? All right. Hearing none, let us vote.
President Alhamdani?
Yes.
Dr. Harris?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Reinhardt?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Ms. Wiegany?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Motion passes. Your next recommendation.
This is, I recommend approval of the following temporary board advances.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded by Dr. Pickett. These temporary board advances, board members, is to pretty much take the money out of general and pay these, and then we'll pay ourselves back once we get the actual funds from the federal government and other titles, correct?
Yeah, all of these are from advance to federal government
Yep, grants.
And a grant, because we get this one on reimbursement basis.
Right.
So when we get the money, we will repay general fund.
Okay. Cool. Any questions on that, board members? All right, hearing none, let us vote.
President Alhamdani?
Yes.
Dr. Harris?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Reiner?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mrs. Wiegany?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
All right. Are there any other recommendations, Madam Treasurer?
That concludes my recommendations. Thank you.
All right, I think we're ready to adjourn. Before we adjourn, I want to thank, since this is technically, this is the end of the fiscal year and the school year for us, and we're closing it out. I want to thank both our Dr. Lally, our superintendent, and our treasurer, Zabraha, for their hard work this year. I know it was a difficult year for everybody. I want to thank everybody that made this year possible, and let's go get another great year under our belts. So appreciate all the work you guys do. I'll take a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
I believe our vice president moved it, and then seconded by Dr. Pickett. Any questions on adjournment? Hearing none, let us vote.
President Alhamdani?
Yes.
Dr. Harris?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Reiner?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mrs. Wiegany?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Motion passes. We're adjourned. You all have a great evening. Take care.
All right. Thank you. Same to you.